Hi, this is JC with Route4Me. Who do we have on the call?
Hi, my name is Jake.
Hey, Jake, how are you today?
I'm doing well today. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good, thank you. Let's go ahead and get started today with your Route4Me session. Jake, what questions do you have about your trial?
Yeah, thank you. So I have a bunch of salespeople out in the road, what's happening is with my growth, they are expanding into each other's zones, I'm really looking for a way to kind of analyze the zones that they're in and making sure that they're not getting into each other's zones and getting too close to each other and finding new customers near other people's zones and divide that up a little bit better, and I was hoping that Route can help me out with that.
So you gave them specific territories, and you don't want them to go and overlap?
Yep, that's correct. I definitely don't want to overlap.
Okay, sounds good. Alrighty, well, I'll show you how you can accomplish that with Route4Me, and not only divide them properly and make sure they're not running on top of each other, but you can also create sequence for their visits, so they can be, efficient and productive at all times while they're on the road, all right? So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to go into our Route4Me account. And from here, when you log in into Route4Me, the first thing you'll see is your previously saved routes, which every time you plan a route, it saves automatically, which is really helpful because every time your reps create their own routes and plan their day, you'll be able to go into your list of routes and see basically how they're planning their routes, making sure they're being efficient, and you can actually take a look at what they're doing live, at the moment that they're out there working. Absolutely. All they have to do is just use the mobile application, which is going to be very helpful, very easy for them because they can add notes to the stops, they can keep track of what they've been doing, they can collect pictures, maybe do different things that they can use as sales tools to make sure and keep them up to date with their customers. All right.
Yeah. Most of my drivers have Android devices. Does it support Android?
That shouldn't be a problem, right? Our mobile application is designed for Android and iOS devices.
Great.
Okay. So the main functionality that I want you to see today is our address book. On the left-hand side, as you can see on my screen, I'm going to go into the address book, and I'm going to choose address book map. Now from here, you'll be able to see how we can create territories. Okay, so as you can see right now, I have a group of addresses on a map, and I have three different territories. Okay.
Yep.
On the right-hand side, you can see the tool draw a new territory, and this is how you can actually create a shape and separate your drivers from one another, or your reps from one another. So you can see how I can name it Drew, John, Mary. So let's go ahead and create one for you, okay?
Yep.
You said it was Kevin, right?
My name's Jake.
Jake, I'm sorry, Jake. I apologize. All right, Jake, so let's go ahead and do this. And let's choose a color that I didn't use before. Let's go with red. All right?
Yep.
So if you notice, I just clicked the Draw New Territory. I named it, select a color, and add. Okay?
Yep.
So now, all I have to do is just zoom in a little bit, and then just grab Jake's territory like this. You see that?
Yep.
Every click or every corner, every dot that you see there is a click and release. So let's just drag it over here. Make sure that we cover that one. And there it is, Jake's territory. So what Jake can do now is go into the territory that he's assigned to. And he can basically and probably create like a sub-territory just by doing this. Same process. Let's say Jake 1. We're going to grab a little lighter color in there, add it, and say maybe Jake wants to go to this customer's on Mondays, okay? Just like that. So whatever is inside Jake's territory will have an additional name, and you can create territories within the territory to make sure they're being efficient every day.
Wow, okay.
What do you think?
Yeah, Terry told me territory. Nice.
Yeah. All right. So let's say we don't need to see that. And as you can tell, each territory will tell you how many stops are inside each territory. Okay. And as you click on them, the system will basically move the map over and show you the one that you're looking at. You see how that works?
Yeah, great. Right. Yeah, so would then, I be able to see all the drivers on here?
Absolutely. You're tracking. If you activate the tracking, you can actually see where the drivers are at all times. Let me see if I can find one. No, there it is. See, there's one of our guys using the mobile application. And all I did was just activate the tracking functionality on their users so that we can see our drivers and where they are in relation to the route.
Great, yeah. It's definitely nice to be able to see all my salespeople on the road at once.
Absolutely. In fact, if this was one of your sales guys, you'll probably be
in lots of trouble. You
know, in lots of trouble and having a nice margarita there by the beach. Anyways, so this is how the territories will work. In fact, this is what we're going to do. We're going to create a route with your territory. So basically what I'm doing right now is selecting them all, and then deselect them so that I don't have anyone. And then I'll select Jake's territory. Click on that drop down for the gear section, the gear icon.
Yep.
Click plan route. And let's say we're going to plan one big route for all his territory and make sure that he knows how to follow the sequence. Okay? So we're going to say Jake. We're going to set up a departure. You can type in a whole new address, or you can just simply grab one from the selection. So we're just going to randomly grab one right here. We're going to schedule. Now, it's very important that you schedule the routes. Basically, if they're going to have their own territory and they're going to schedule when they're going to go visit, you know, different areas within their territory, they want to schedule this. And let's say Jake wants to do this on Monday. He's going to start around 9 a.m. And he's going to spend about, let's say, 20 minutes per stop. Is that about right?
Yep, that's about right.
Okay. So then we jump into the optimization, and he's going to plan a single driver route, and he can create a route that will end at any address, like this.
Yep.
And basically let the system tell him or tell you where to finish the route. You can do a round trip and basically have the system create a route or an optimization based on a sequence that will bring the driver back to the departure point when you can end at last address. And this option is really very specific, because you can actually select which address you want to finish the route with. And so the system will have a departure point and an end point, and will route everything in between. Maybe sales reps have a specific appointment at the end of the day, and they want to make sure that they do that at the end. You follow me?
Yep.
Fantastic. All right, so once we do that, this time we're going to create a route and end at any address. We're just going to create it. There's a weather notification that comes up. You can always apply the changes depending on your weather conditions, because traffic, it's affected by it, but you can always skip it if you want it. So I'm just going to skip it for now. And there it is. Within the Route4Me, an activity feed will be created so that you can see what's happening on those on each route or on each stop, depending on what the driver has been doing, interacting with the mobile application. From here, they can add addresses to the route. They can actually find areas where they can see additional customers. They can re-optimize the route, they can make changes to the sequence, etc., right?
Yeah, okay, what about documenting? Is there any features for documenting while they're on the road?
Absolutely. In fact, I was going to show you that. So we're going back to the address book map. And from here, you'll be able to see, all of your stops. And then when you go to hover on top of every single stop, you can edit, and you can access options like color coding the customers. Let's say that we're going to choose the red color. We're going to create a window of opportunity. Maybe you want to create some sort of an appointment, right?
Yep.
On which you're used to visiting that customer. And then you can also add custom data. Say, for example, you can add last visited or last visit. You can add, what else do you think would be good?
Who we spoke with.
Yeah, contact.
Yep, contact name.
Something like that. And then you can create those, and you can export those fields after you're done to a CSV file that you can then manage your data. Or all of this can be added into an Excel file. When you upload your addresses onto your address book, you can add additional columns like phone numbers, emails, notes, you know, etc. All the any type of custom data that you want to relate to each address as you progress using the system. In fact, what we're going to do now is I'm going to save it, and you're going to see how that changed in color. So you can assign colors to your stops. So you can say red for hot leads, you can say blue for inactive, or green for, you know, paying customers, etc. What do you think?
Yeah, I think it looks great. It's really important that I can look on the map and see my drivers and make sure they're not going into each other's zones. That's been a big problem where I'll just notice that a driver is near a zone that the other driver should have gone to. So this should be very helpful for us.
Fantastic. Yeah, like I said, you know, the Route4Me will actually help your drivers and provide them with a good sequence so they stay as productive as possible throughout their day. Not only that, but your managers can also log in, and like I said, you know, they can track your sales reps' activities live. Okay?
Yep.
So, excellent. So, let's go ahead and implement this into your operation. The only thing we have to do is just activate your account. We'll put you through the onboarding process, which is training sessions, so that you and your managers can learn how to use all the functionalities, and we'll move on from there, okay?
Great. Thank you very much, JC.
You got it. You got it, Jake. I'll send you that email right now, okay? Talk to you later. Have a good one.